Today, I'm going to show you how I redesign a logo. So it's been so long since I last filmed a logo related video. If you haven't seen my previous ones, I will leave them linked on screen and in the description so you can check those out. But if you didn't know, I'm moving house soon. So I thought we'll have one last hurrah. And I'm like, this is the last time I'm filming in this setup. So I have been challenged by MSI to do a logo redesign video. MSI is a world leader in gaming and content creation solutions. So they've actually provided me with a laptop for today's video. And this laptop has been created with the golden ratio in mind. So looking at the MSI logo, that in itself has been created with the golden ratio, making it look sleek, beautiful, and sophisticated. So I'm ready for the challenge. Let's get into the video. This is the logo that we are redesigning, and the lovely Alice has sent it over. Great name. And Alice says she runs a small business and it's called Mundi Moos. I wasn't quite sure on the pronunciation. Apologies in advance, Alice. Currently, the logo is just in black letters with the leaf design underneath it. She said she'd like something more floral or more wow and eye-catching, something really professional that would carry it through if it ever became something more than a side hustle. So I really liked this. I feel like we're starting with a pretty clean blank slate and I thought I could really go to town with the creativity. As I always say in these videos, my number one thing that I do is head over to Pinterest and find some inspiration. So what I like to do, I'll create a board for that particular client or viewer in this case, and I'm gonna go through and kind of search things that I like the look of. So I went for like floral, I went for modern, I went for triangle. Actually, I quite liked the idea of using a triangle in there somewhere, and I just wanted to sort of piece together some ideas. So once I've saved a bunch of things on the Pinterest board, I like to revisit it and I'll download a couple of images that I really think fit this brief and that I want to sort of use as inspiration. Next, I move over to Illustrator, and what I've done is I've created two identical artboards. The one on the left has all the inspo photos and the existing logo, and the one on the right is the one that we're gonna experiment on. First task before I design is to gather some fonts. So I always use Adobe fonts. It is all within my Adobe Creative Cloud subscription, so they're all free and they sync straight to Illustrator, which makes it very, very easy and efficient. So I usually download and save about 5 fonts and I actually write them down on a piece of paper so I remember which ones they are. And then when we have got those, I go back into Illustrator and I'm gonna sort of compare them against each other. So we actually ended up with 4 different fonts and you can see they are similar but different. Straight away, I could spot the ones that I didn't love. So I got rid. I didn't want to use those at all. Sometimes this like process of elimination leaves me with a font that I absolutely love and I know I want to use. However, in this case, it didn't. So don't be afraid to go back to the drawing board, back to Adobe fonts, and find some more fonts that you like, which is exactly what I did. So I actually downloaded 2 more fonts and these fonts were more along the lines that I was going for. I think I was kind of struggling to visualize what I wanted on the first round. So this time round, we did it right. And that's what's really important about graphic design, is to remember that nothing's permanent. You can always go back, you can always change your mind, and that's why I love the digital format of it. In the end, I actually narrowed it down to the font called Lust, but I really liked the addition of the font above it where the O's are turned slightly, so I decided to play around with it. I used the touch type tool, which allows you to move each character. It allows you to like nudge them up and down, change the angles, change the tracking, etc. I really recommend that tool if you want to have a play around with fonts and make them your own rather than just sticking with how they came out of the box, you know. And of course, thank you to MSI for providing the laptop that I created this design on. The laptop is actually their new Z16 laptop and it is beautiful. The performance on this laptop is insane. One really fun aesthetic thing about it is the fact that the keyboard is rainbow. That just like fully mesmerized me. But I mean, there are a lot of tech features, so I'm just going to quickly talk you through those. And if you're interested in a new laptop, I highly recommend checking out this one from MSI. So this MSI laptop is a sleek and elegant design. It's a beautiful laptop and it actually features the golden ratio display, which is 16 by 10, which makes the viewing slash working area wider and enhances the productivity. The screen supports QHD high resolution content and it uses MSI color precision technology, which is customizable to create eye-popping and authentic content. The screen is actually also touchscreen, so as you're working, you can use that touchscreen to really get into and interact with your work. There's a super fast rendering time, and this is really, really important towards creators. I need to make sure my laptop is fast and keeps up with my video editing and graphic design software. Now, all in all, I know this is a lot of technical jargon, and I myself don't completely understand it. It all adds up to a really pleasant user experience. You can add extra monitors to further enhance your workspace. I also connected my Bluetooth mouse and keyboard in about 2 seconds, so I could add this laptop into my existing work setup with no problems at all. So once again, thanks MSI. I'll add all the info and the tech specs in the description, and yeah, let's get back into designing this logo. So as you can see, I'm sort of changing the stacking on this. I was toying with the idea of having it sort of staggered and combining the serifs and sort of playing around with the two M's, and it took a while, honestly. I think I spent about half an hour just fiddling with the placement. But long story short, I played around with the layout and I ended up with 2 different versions. So I actually ended up changing the letter M. I realized that the lowercase one made a little bit bigger. I actually preferred, and I also actually decided to add the studios part of the name in there too. I could easily get rid of this if at any point I sent it to the client. They might not want that on. I can get rid of that. Another great tip that I like to share is to play around with the tracking. So if you go up into the character menu, you'll be able to see the tracking option. And if you increase or decrease the value, it'll change the space between the letters. You can see that I'm playing around with the word studio. Like I said, rather than just using the font out of the box as it came, this is a really easy way of personalizing it and making it look more sleek and professional. Okay, so now we've got a basic layout. I have already started playing around with some like icons and elements that I can include. Now, I'm not an illustrator, so I don't feel comfortable drawing my own icons very often. Sometimes I have a bit of inspo, but this time I thought I would leave it to the professionals. So I actually like to download my icons and elements and stuff from a website called Envato. I've talked about them a lot. They're linked in the description. But I found a bunch of different flowers. I found some moons. And I mean, you can see there's a lot of different things that I was playing around with. And I sort of wanted to have a go with that placement. Remember when I mentioned the triangle at the beginning? I was playing with that. I wanted to try a square, a rectangle, and I mean, it speaks for itself. You can see that I went through a lot of different layouts and different processes to sort of find what I liked. And then the penny hit. Wait, is that the phrase? I don't know. And then I realized that I really liked the sort of archway vibe. And as you can see from the inspo photo, I'd already sort of got that on my radar. So I decided to make an archway and incorporate the flowers because Alice asked for some floral elements. And I actually really like it. I think it looks really classy. However, it does work by itself as just the font. So I think this would be the stage where if it was a proper client brief rather than a redesign, I'd send it back to the client and be like, which way do you prefer? I've now got the basic design down. As you've seen, it's been in black and white the whole time. I don't like to mess around with colors too early on. This is just a personal thing. I find colors the hardest part, mainly because I'm so indecisive. And obviously in this case, the client hasn't told me which colours they like. So I had like free reign of the entire colour spectrum, which is actually a little bit of a curse because I just can't decide. So you'll see that I'm using the colour option. Another tip, if you go into edit and edit colours, you can change the colours really easily. You just sort of press the mix up button, I don't know what it's called, and it lets you flick between different colour palettes. Now, I download my colour palettes from Adobe Color. Similar to Adobe Fonts, it's included with a subscription and it syncs straight to your computer. So I went in, I found some like earthy tones with pops of colour and I saved maybe like 4 or 5 different colour palettes. Now, I'm going to speed this up a lot because I took my time doing this and it took me a while and I'm still not 100% sure on the colour combos, so please let me know in the comments of the video how you would have gone about these colours, because I really can't settle on it and it's annoying me. But yeah, as you can see, I sort of came to an idea, and what I'm doing is laying out the different elements of the logo. So you can see that at the top is the main logo and I want to display it on different color backgrounds so the client can sort of visualize what it would look like in white on a black background, etc. So I did different variations of it. I dragged out that arch with the flower in, showed that a few ways, and then I actually had to play around with the two M's to sort of combine those. So I'm thinking like a little Instagram icon, or maybe the favicon at the top of a website could be the two M's, or a little sign off on the bottom of an email, something like that. So I want to make sure we had an icon in there too. So that's pretty much the logo itself done. I am actually really happy with it, minus the colours. The colours is something that isn't sitting well with me. There's something I've missed there. So this is where I want you to help me. Let me know in the comments what you'd do differently, because it's been so long since I filmed one of these, I'm not quite sure. And then one final tip before I love you and leave you is to present your logos in mockups, so whoever you're showing the logo to can really visualize it. I like to use business card mockups. I actually created one with a stamp. I've done a little like tag, so if she was selling garments, you could add that as a little tag. So that's my final tip of the video. Use mockups. That's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you to MSI for challenging me to do this. It's been a great little throwback. I'm very glad I had this one last hurrah in my current office before I move house. Don't forget to check out the Z16 laptop that MSI very kindly provided for this video. I will leave all the info and the link in the description, like I said. And yeah, say goodbye to this office, guys, because the next one, I presume, is going to be in the new one. Don't forget to subscribe if you aren't already. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.